Hello and welcome to my Vintage Audiophile channel. This is now my 73rd video. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Denon D700 Executive Bookshelf System. Denon's known for many years to make quality products, and this is no exception. This is actually one of the best bookshelf systems that I own. It weighs quite a bit. I'd say it probably weighs about 30 pounds. A lot of that has to do with the amplifier, which has a huge transformer in it for good quality sound. Nice thing about this one too, unlike some of them, is that this one does come with a remote that can control everything that's on the executive's bookshelf system. And that makes it much easier to use, especially if you're across the room. There's probably a few little buttons here and there that you have to do manually, like the balance control. But other than that, everything else is pretty much all on the remote control. So without further ado, I'm going to turn the power on. As you can see at the top there in the amplifier, it's flashing red right now. It does that for a few seconds until the relay kicks in, and then it becomes yellow, meaning it's ready to go. The yellow indicator light there shows that it's at minimum volume. I will use the remote here to turn the volume up. As you can see, it's a motorized volume, so it's going up. Right now I have it on tape one. I'm going to turn it to tuner, and that's where we're going to start at. This has 30 presets that you can set into it. I think right now I have 26 presets, and those are all stations that I can get pretty clearly here where I live. I could fill it up with 30 if I wanted to get some of the other stations that aren't that clear and are farther away, but for this demonstration, all we need to do is listen to a few of the stations to show you how it works. And I am going to turn it on now to tuner so that you can hear that it is working. Turn it down a little bit here. Right now it's on preset one. And I'll just cycle through here. Some of the channels don't come in at all the time, and that's okay with me because they're channels I don't usually listen to anyways.
A lot of people losing power, including our own Molly Pettit.
As you can see, it works. I am going to now use the tape section on here, and that has a quite comprehensive amount of buttons on here. Nice thing about this one is it's all fully automatic, but the only thing you don't have on here to push that you have to set yourself is the Dolby off B or C. Otherwise, everything else is on here. And it has auto reverse on both decks, as well as fast forward reverse. Deck 2 has a record on it so that you can record from whatever source you're listening to at the time, whether it be CD, tuner, auxiliary, VCR, or phono. There is a phono jack on this, a dedicated phono jack. The old-fashioned style with the RCA plugs and the ground wire, which makes it nice for those who have their older ones. Of course, if you have a newer one that doesn't have that kind of stuff on it with the, but has the built-in preamp, you can hook it up to auxiliary and use it that way also. And you'll be able to control the sound. And as far as the volume wise is concerned with the remote, of course you'll have to do everything manually on the turntable that you have, but you can control the sound and stuff like that. Control the equalizer. While I'm talking about the equalizer, I should probably tell you exactly what we have here. Here we have the amplifier, we have the tuner, and which also doubles as the input part of the machine too, so that you can change the different inputs. We have a dedicated graphic equalizer that also doubles as a surround sound, sort of. This particular receiver accepts two pairs of speakers. There is a simulated surround button on the equalizer so that you can listen to all four speakers at once in a simulated home theater style setting. It does have a three disc changer that has all your standard buttons on it, your fast forward, rewind, so to speak, of the tracks, play, pause, stop, and then you've got your disc 1, 2, and 3 that you can select either from the CD itself or from the remote. Of course, it's easier with the remote, and the two well cassette deck that plays really nice. So I'm going to put on a tape here. I have a tape in deck 1, so I'm going to play that at the moment. And then you can also auto reverse it, play the other side of the tape. And then of course you got your fast forward and rewind. And I'm going to take, this is about the only other thing you need to do manually, is if you want to change cassettes or add cassettes, you can do that. As you notice, I'm putting in tape 2, and as soon as you put tape 2 in there, it changes to tape 2. And as you can see, that all works. As far as this demo goes, the main part of the receiver has been accomplished, except for CD player. So I'm going to put a CD on now, and I am going to put it on CD1. And I'm going to go to the last CD on this track on the CD. One other thing on here that is on here that I don't think I can control with the remote, because I've never been able to figure it out. Doesn't mean it's not there, I just don't know which button to push. There is a thing on here for a bass boost. Right now it's on standard. We got two different levels of bass boost on here. And of course at low volumes it doesn't really matter, but if you crank it up a bit, you can definitely tell the difference in the bass between bass boost and not. And That's the demo part of the den in itself. I don't have the matching speakers for this anymore because they went bad on me. Played a little too loud at times and blew the speakers up, but I am using a very comparable three-way Sony bookshelf speakers that I've used in other demos because I really like them. I just never talked about them much. And the only other thing I've got to demonstrate in this right now, if I may move this up a little bit, is I do have a record player turn hooked up to this right now. So I am going to turn this on. I am going to put it into phono, which it is right now. Forgive me for the pops and ticks there. I'm playing a record that is about 63 years old, so it's been around a while. It does pick up a few ticks here and there over the years, but it is one of the very early stereo records that came out at that time, and it still sounds really good. I still have it on the bass boost, so that's why it sounded a little bassy.
I can almost smell the perfume.
There's a little bit of a demo of that.
I can all
a little bit of mellow music to wind down the demonstration. But as you can see, and of course each one of these pieces is a separate unit. They just stack on top of each other, so you can take them and put them in any configuration you want. You can stack them beside each other so that they're not so tall, so that they do fit on a bookshelf that you may have, or if you just don't like something that looks that tall, you can also do that too. There's enough different sizes here that you can make any combination you want to get them to be the exact height of a double stack. And then along with the speakers that you can put anywhere. And if you have long speaker cords, you can take the second pair of speakers and put them somewhere else in a room so that you can immerse yourself in great sounding music. Of course, it's was made in the 90s, I think 1997, if I remember right. And that's the pre Bluetooth era, so there is no Bluetooth on this. You'd have to buy yourself a Bluetooth adapter to be able to broadcast, or in this case, receive stuff from like your phone or a Bluetooth stereo turntable. They do make them that are like just little boxes that you can plug into the headphone jack. This one does have the standard old-fashioned eighth inch jack, which means you'd have to have an eighth inch to a quarter inch adapter, which is not a big deal, but you could stick something in there if you wanted to and be able to play your phone on there, put your iTunes on, or put Pandora or Spotify or iHeartRadio or TuneIn or whatever, Sirius XM, whatever it is that you normally listen to, and you could listen to it through this system, no problem. But that is for another demonstration some other time. I've demonstrated a little bit of Bluetooth technology before in the past, but for that Reach Wireless thing that you can plug into anything that has a headphone jack and be able to listen to your Bluetooth headphones through it. I have a friend at work that saw my video, and now he's listening to his wired headphones through this Reach wireless thing, and it's syncs with his iPhone, and he can listen to music all day long on his headphone that he previously couldn't use because he didn't have a jack on his phone to plug his headphones into. So technology is great for the most part. Some things are better left to be undiscovered, but technology in general has been very kind to the universe. And so that is my demonstration of this Denon D700. I believe it was one of the top of the line ones they ever made, and it sounds it. I'm not even sure how much watts this puts out, but it can crank a lot. The older I get, the less I crank it out anymore, but I have, like I say, I have done in the past, cranked it pretty loud, and I blew out the original speakers, so it does have quite a bit of power. So if you like this demonstration, and I hope you do, please subscribe to my channel and please give this video a like. You can also leave any comments you have. Let me know that, hey, you've got the same one too, or you wish you had one, or whatever the situation may be. And I hope that you can stay safe, and hope you have a great day. And until next time, when I do my 74th video, I will see you then. Thank you very much. Good night.